Frontier Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Aaron Landry is going to go all the way to the house. Landry gets the outside again.
Lovely on the carry. Not-
breaks through and he's into the end zone. He is dropped in the backfield by Kieran Freeman. First handoff. Nice little bit of razzle dazzle there as the handoff went to Worley, then it went to Landry, and Landry's off to the races. Touchdown! No Wanter just plowed through three or four tacklers. Frontier Red Hawk football. Ten. Five. Frontier Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Tonight, the Western Mass Division IV semifinals. The number one seed Wahconah Warriors hosting the number four seed Frontier Redhawks. Hi again, everyone. I'm Chris Collins. Kevin Murphy's alongside. We are here at a very, very cold Wahconah Regional High School field. Upcoming, a very interesting matchup between two teams that some would say this was destined that these two teams would meet in the playoffs. I know that talking to the Frontier kids earlier this year, a lot of them said that to win the a Super Bowl or go to a Super Bowl, they have to go through Wahconah, and that's exactly what the situation is tonight. Last week, of course, Frontier lost to Turner's Falls, and at the end of that game, we were all kind of convinced that Frontier's playoff hopes had been dashed, but thanks to the Walker system and East Hampton qualifying and Gardner not qualifying, Frontier was able to edge out Athol in the Walker rankings, and they wind up in this game today as the number four seed here, taking on the Wahconah Warriors in the Berkshire, from Berkshire County up here in Dalton. Frontier comes in banged up, to say the least. They are missing two of their bigger players, two of their better players. Running back Seth Gawanter and Steve Wordley were hurt in last week's game against Turner's. Gawanter, of course, with the severe sprained ankle, and Wordley with that very scary concussion and neck injury that caused him to be taken off the field on a stretcher in the waning seconds of that game. Those two have a combined 837 yards and 11 touchdowns between them, and they're both out for the year. So the Redhawks' running game is somewhat in flux, somewhat limited, and the 7-1 Warriors come in with one of the more potent offenses in Western Mass. They average 39.5 points per game, and they only give up an average of 15 points per game. Their only loss this year was a 28-18 setback to Berkshire County rival Taconic, who happened to be the top seed in Division III. Their big gun is quarterback Will Genoway. He has thrown for nearly 1,000 yards, 17 touchdowns, and 330 yards rushing with six touchdowns with his feet. So that's a pretty strong kid back there in the pocket. Wahconah also has some other ground weapons. Genoway, running backs Connor Noyes and Tanner Hastings. They've each combined for about 1,100 yards and a total of 13 touchdowns. And he's got some wideouts he can throw to. Connor Washburn has 19 catches, 9 touchdowns, averages 24.8 yards per catch. And Connor Matthews has 3 TDs, and he's caught 10 balls for 190 yards this season. And as I mentioned, the Warriors are very tough defensively, and they're also familiar with the Redhawks' offense. The Redhawks run a double wing formation, and quite honestly, they've seen that before. They watched the double wing very closely when they took on Holliston in the 2014 state final, a game that Wahconah actually
won. Good evening,
won.
Ladies and gentlemen. Welcome
and with the run game depleted, Frontier will depend on the arm of Miles Freeman a little more. He's only attempted 31 passes, but has 15 completions this year for 394 yards and 3 touchdowns. His only interception he threw last week against Turner's Falls. Both teams' captains now walking out to the field, in the center of the field. Seth Gawanter is out there on crutches, as you can see, that the severely
Warriors,
sprained ankle. I don't know if Steve Worley's on the sidelines, but Redhawks came in looking in the warm-ups pretty controlled, pretty calm. They know they're in a fight, though. This is going to be probably the toughest test they've had all year. And, you know, the Turner's game notwithstanding, that was a loss, but this is a whole different animal. This is the playoffs. This is the Wahconah team. It's big, strong, lots of numbers, and they think they're a team of destiny this year. They want to go all the way. So we'll see what happens and see who gets the first crack at the football, which could be very, very important. Of course, the Redhawks still have Aaron Landry in the backfield. You'll see a lot of him. I think you'll see Dalton DeForest get some touches, Joe Morawski. Cole Price and Kiernan Freeman will be the wideout threats for Miles Freeman, and they were practicing a lot of short passes in pregame, so I would expect to see Miles throw the ball a lot more than he normally does. Typically, this three-headed monster of a running attack has been what Frontier has leaned on.
Frontier
has
won the toss.
No longer. Frontier will win. Won the toss and will, I believe, receive the basket of the basketball, the football. Get ahead of myself here.
And they
will receive. So that could be big. And they're going to run from right to left to start this game.
Frontier will receive from the south goal.
I don't think a lot of people are giving Frontier a chance. Certainly nobody in the recorder today, including myself, gave them a chance to win this game. But it'd be a great morale boost if they could win this one. Okay, the time for talking is over. It's time to play some football. And this is going to be a very, very interesting contest on a number of levels. What will be interesting to see is how the Frontier defense also can contain, if they can, the Warriors of Wahconah without Worthley and Gawanter in the lineup. They're both very effective linebackers, and not having them in there is going to be yet another test. Back deep for Frontier is Matt Hildreth.
For Frontier, Matt Hildreth.
Aaron Landry.
And Aaron Landry.
Both are standing at the 5-yard line. Deep kick. Landry will take it at the 3. Up the middle, gets a block and gets up past the 20-yard line, which is where we will start. First
Aaron
and 10.
Landry with a 25-yard return.
From the 20 to the 22-yard line.
Frontier takes over, first and 10.
Well, this first series will be very interesting. If in fact, the pregame speculation is true, you might just see Miles Freeman throw on first down here. It wouldn't surprise me. He shoots the shotgun, trips to the right, and in motion goes Landry. Landry gets the handoff around right end, gets the corner. He's got first down yardage, out past the 40 to about the 44-yard line. It's not a bad first down play there at all. We're going to say he stepped out, though, at the 30, so cut back the
gain of 9 on the play.
So he got 9, didn't get the first down, but got 9 as he stepped out of bounds at the 31, but a very good first down play. That motion counter and the shift to the shotgun. Second and 1 from the 31-yard line. He shifts the shotgun again. Inside handoff, and they got the first down. So a very different look for Frontier. They're not running the double wing. They're shifting to a last-second shotgun, and they've got first down yardage.
Well,
so definitely, Don Gordon has changed things up offensively to adjust for the lack of that power offense that they had all year long.
35.
First and 10 from the 35. Freeman under center. Once again, shifts to the shotgun. Same formation. And Freeman's going to keep it on first down. Runs right side. Gets some good yardage, is out close to midfield. We'll see where they spot it. But again, Frontier moving the ball very well. It's going to be second and about 3. So we got 7 on that one, and the ball is spotted at the 44-yard line. Call it second and 2. At the 43. 11:08 to go, first quarter, no score. Frontier with the ball and moving. Shotgun again, this time it goes right side over right tackle, and ball is spotted. It's going to be a first down.
Lopez on the carry, picks up the first down.
First down at midfield for the Frontier Redhawks, who are in business.
First and 10 Frontier from their own 45.
At the 45-yard line for Frontier. Shotgun again. Inside give, doesn't go far. Brought down at the line of scrimmage. And that was Joe Morosky carried that ball.
On the carry.
Got maybe a half a yard. Call it second and about 9
Brandon Hoffman. No gain on the play, second and 10.
Once again, Miles Freeman in the shotgun. He's going to pass. And the pass intended from Rosky over his head, incomplete. That'll bring up
Freeman pass intended
for
Rosky is incomplete. Brings up a third and 10.
It's a very interesting little wrinkle here, going to the shotgun. And they've been able to spread things out a little bit and get some good yards. But so far, right now, at least, the drive has stalled as Wahconah has made an adjustment. Once again, Miles in the gun. In motion comes Landry. Landry gets it. Hand off around left end, and he gets wrapped up and brought down at about the 40. That time, the Wahconah ends were not fooled, and they were able to wrap up Landry. And it looks like Frontier will have to punt it away. That's just good defense right there. Boy, those Wahconah ends are speedy to be able to catch up with Landry on a play like that.
It's called loss of 5.
It's going to bring up fourth and about 15 in a punting situation for the Hawks. So all in all, pretty good first series, but it stalls out at the 45. High snap over the head of Freeman. And the flags are flying everywhere. Let's see what they get.
On the play.
That's actually a lucky break for Frontier, because that snap would have put them way back and given Wahconah a great field position. So they lose 5 yards. It'll be 4th and 20. And Miles will be kicking it from 5 yards deeper, but it's better than the bad snap that occurred. Freeman, better snap, gets the punt off, a high arcing punt. Bounces and rolls and will be brought down at about the 36-yard line of the Warriors.
Punt is downed by Hildreth, the Frontier.
So Wahconah will get their first whack at it.
From their own 37.
And again, they have the big quarterback, Genoway, He's got all kinds of weapons. Let's see what kind of defense Frontier can put up against these Warriors. Genoa comes out with nobody in the backfield. Trips to the left. And it's going to be a draw. Up the middle, still pushing to about the 45-yard line.
Hastings on the carry.
That was Tanner Hastings, number 21. He gets 9 on that one. Second and 1.
Red Hawk.
On the 46.
Second and 1.
Two near side wideouts. And the shotgun. Pass to the outside is complete. And cutting up and into Frontier territory is number 2, Connor Washburn. He went out of bounds at about the Frontier 40. So it'll be first and 10, Wahconah from the Frontier 40. 8:30 to go in the first quarter, no score. This is Wakona's first offensive touch of the ball.
First and 10 for the Warriors. From the Frontier 40.
And the shotgun again. He's rolling out on first down. Looking deep. Fires it downfield, way over the head of the intended receiver. No good. That'll bring up second and 10. And that was Connor Washburn again. He was down at about the 5, but well covered. We'll bring up second and 10.
Up second and 10.
In the gun. Fumble.
Fumble.
Who got it?
Connor Noyes recovers the fumble.
Yeah, that was looked like a bit of formation, a little bit of a wildcat formation. He still ended up getting 3 yards out of it, even though there was a fumble. So, ball spotted at about the 37-yard line, just inside the 37 of Frontier.
He's up a third and 7.
Genoa in the shotgun again. He has double wideouts on the near side. Now in motion goes Washburn. And the give goes off right tackle. And the Warriors are deep into Frontier territory. And that was Hastings. Huge hole blown open on the right side. And that's going to bring up a first and 10 at about the 12 of the Red Hawks.
First and 10 for the Warriors. Frontier 13.
Out to the left side. Genoa rolling out. Good protection. Fires it across the middle. Touchdown. So Tom Burris with the touchdown, 13 yards. Pass from Genoa. Makes it 6-0 with the extra point upcoming. Kick is up. And it is no good. Actually, the kick was good, so we'll come back up the field with the score. We're calling 7. Frontier nothing. This is Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. An impressive first drive, a variation of runs and passes, and ends up in 7 points and an early lead for the Wahconah Warriors. Frontier will get the ensuing kickoff. Once again, Hildreth and Landry are back deep at the Red Hawk 5.
Matt Hildreth back deep for the Red Hawk. Along with Aaron Landry, Butler to kick off for the Warriors.
Patrick Butler was making routine kickoffs, routine rather field goal attempts from 45 yards out in a warm-up. So this kid, if gets the opportunity, can put a leg on the ball. And he does it again, very deep kick. Hildreth will take it at the two. Fumbles, gets it back up. And Hildreth will be brought down at about the 14, 15 yard line. Good pursuit by Wahconah, and Frontier will start off with a long field. First and 10 Frontier from their own 15 yard line. Morawski's the near side wide out, and the shotgun is Freeman. Inside give. Gets about 3 or 4 yards. Let's see who they gave it to. That was Landry on the run. Sorry, Joe Morawski, excuse me. That's going to bring up a second and 7.
Being three on the play.
For Frontier. 6:42 to go in the first
second
quarter.
7.
7-0 Wahconah. Shotgun again. The inside give this time, I believe, goes to Landry, it looks like. He gets up past the 20 to about the 21-yard line, well, about the 20-yard line or so. That'll bring up third and about 4.
Three more on the play, brings up a third and 4.
Freeman rolls out, fires it over the middle, into a crowd, incomplete. Lots of blue shirts there. Pass was intended, it looked like, for Cole Price.
Incomplete.
And Landry was also out there, but bring up a fourth again, 4th and 4. And they have to punt it away. Miles Freeman back deep to kick it for the Redhawks. And Freeman boots it away. And the ball bounces and it's picked up at about the 45. And the Wahconah player is brought down. That brings a cheer from the Frontier sidelines. Good pursuit by the Redhawks. And the Warriors will take over at about their own 41-yard line.
Wahconah will take over, 1st and 10. From their own 42.
See if the Redhawks have an answer for the Warriors, who moved the ball pretty well in that last series that they scored on. Trips to the left side. And the shotgun. And fires it downfield, incomplete. A little contact there with Hildreth, but no call. That'll bring up 2nd and 10. Genoway, very smooth. Got a good arm, obviously, and has had good protection so far tonight. I don't get the sense that the Warriors are as dominant as we thought they might be, although this game is early going. Double wide out to the near side. Genoway is going to throw again. Pass incomplete. Went through the hands of, looks like, Connor Washburn. And that'll bring up 3rd down. Actually, that was
complete. Brings up a 3rd and 10.
So 3rd and 10. Two incomplete passes back to back for Genoway. In the shotgun again. Same set. He's going to throw again. Pass over the middle, incomplete. And it's going to be a 3 and out, the first one for the Wahconah Warriors. So Frontier, good defense there. And they will be forced to punt for the first time. Interesting that they didn't try at least one running play in that series, but Genoway clearly testing the secondary of Frontier, which has been a question mark this year. They haven't been tested all that much in the secondary, but they answered the call that time.
Landry back deep.
And they're not gonna pass. They're gonna pass on 4th down and complete over the middle. And the gamble worked as the pass went to Wyatt Schlechter. Well, that shows a tremendous amount of confidence on a 4th and 10 to, rather than go for the punt, to pass it. And that's got to be a confidence booster for Wahconah, and kind of a confidence blast to Frontier. 1st and 10 Wahconah at the 31 of Frontier. Genoway in the shotgun again, and one of his players jumped. That's going to be a 5-yard penalty. So Wahconah sending a message early to Frontier that they're not worried about being in a 4th down situation. They have no problem going for it with that passing game. That'll push the ball back up to the 36 of Frontier with 5 minutes to go in the first quarter. 7-0 Wahconah. They have the ball on a 1st and 15. Chenaway in the gun again. Handoff. Up the right side. And another 1st down. And that was Tanner Hastings, the junior back. Moves the chains again.
1st and 10 Warriors.
1st and 10 Wahconah at the Frontier 19.
From the Red Hawk 19-yard line.
Again, hands off. Tanner, it's the exact same play. That was Noise this time. It's going to be a 1st and goal from the 6 of Frontier. Make it the 7 of Frontier. Genoway in the gun again. Fumble, picks it back up. Fumbles it again near the goal line. Who recovered it, though?
Play recovered by Genoway.
Okay, so Wahconah recovered it, and they recovered the ball at about the 1-yard line. Let's make it the 2. Just outside the 2.
Gain 5 on the play.
And you can gain 5 in a fumble. That's, you're doing pretty well. 2nd and goal from the 2. Genoway in the gun again. Handoff inside. He breaks through and in for the touchdown. That was Noise on a 2-yard run. It makes it 13-0 with the extra point upcoming. Back up the field with the score, Wahconah 14, Frontier nothing. This is Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Here at Wahconah Regional School, this is the Division 4 high school football semifinal, and the Wahconah Warriors are in business. They are up 14-0 on the Frontier Red Hawks, 3:20 to go in the first quarter. 13-yard touchdown pass and a 2-yard run from Noise.
Landry and Hildreth back deep.
And
Butler,
Butler will boot it again to Hildreth and Landry. Again, Frontier playing without Steve Wordley and Seth Gawanter. Deep kick. Hildreth takes it at the 5. Cuts back up the right side. Hildreth's got some speed. He's got one man to beat. Hildreth down the right sideline and knocked out of bounds at about the 41-yard line of Wahconah. So Matt Hildreth, the speedster up the right sideline, the freshman, excuse me, the sophomore, and he's into Wahconah territory. That was all Hildreth and his legs that made that happen. 1st and 10 Frontier from the 44 of Wahconah. This is the first time into Wahconah territory so far. Well, the second time, actually, for Frontier. Miles Freeman has three receivers to the near side. He's going to take on the Wildcat. Freeman over left side and gets down to about the 40-yard line before he's taken down by three Wahconah Warriors. We'll give him probably about three on that one. Right about the 40-yard line, so we'll give him about four. Second and six. 2:45 to go in the first quarter. Miles Freeman again from the gun. And inside handoff goes to Landry. Cuts back the other way. He's close to first down yardage. And that was that little cross buck they used.
Brought down by Fleischer.
And that's going to be a first down for Frontier.
Frontier
at the 33 of Wahconah. So the Hawks starting to move the ball with a little more regularity. Kiernan Freeman is the far side wideout. And again, Freeman takes it on the Wildcat.
Freeman on the carry.
Gets up to about the 30 or so, I think.
Brought down by Gazelle. Gain of one on the play. Is up second and nine.
They're going to spot it at about the 32, it looks like. Second and nine for Frontier. And a timeout, Red Hawks will take the break. 1:45 to go in the first quarter. It's Wahconah 14, Frontier nothing. This is Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television.
Thank you all.
Okay, so the Red Hawks have a third and nine at the Wahconah 32-yard line. They moved the ball pretty well on this series. Kiernan Freeman, the near side wideout. Miles is going to roll out. Quick screen pass goes through the hands of Landry, incomplete. That'll bring up a second, make that a third and nine. Well, they've run that screen with Landry out of the backfield before, and it was a good pass, just a little too hard and bounced through Landry's fingers. Freeman again from the gun. Quick screen pass complete. The right side, and that goes absolutely nowhere. As it was a nice little pass, little flare pass in the flats, and was read well by the Wahconah Warriors defense. And that's a loss of, God, looks like about 6 yards. So fourth and 14. I'm guessing they'll probably go for it here inside of Wahconah territory. It doesn't make a lot of sense to punt.
Brings up a 4th and
14. Wahconah seems to be able to make the big plays when they have to on defense, and that was a big one. 4th and 14. Freeman, actually the snap goes, they faked the punt. So Freeman was set up to kick. They did a fake snap to Landry. It went over his head, and the ball is down and turns over at the 46 of Wahconah. So a little bit of trickery there, which just did not work. And with 48.8 seconds to go in the first quarter, Wahconah will get the ball back at their own 46-yard line. Will Genoway in the shotgun for Wahconah. And he fires one down the right sidelines, looking for Washburn just over his head. Good pursuit there by the Frontier defender. That was Yidlitz, I believe. And also over there was Miles Freeman. That's going to bring up second and 10 at the 45-yard line. Trips to the near side for Genoway. This is going to be an inside give. So I believe Washburn, and he's brought down at about little past midfield at about the Frontier 49-yard line. That was Washburn, and he got about looks like seven on that one. Ball spotted at the Frontier 48. That'll bring up a third and about three, maybe four.
Pick up six on the play, third and four.
And Wahconah calls time. Actually, they're going to let the quarter run out, and that'll be the end of the first quarter. We played one quarter from Wahconah in the Division IV Western Mass semifinals. On the scoreboard, it's Wahconah Warriors 14, the Frontier Redhawks nothing. Redhawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Chris Collins, Kevin Murphy, and Zach Pelk on the cameras here at Wahconah Regional School as the Frontier Redhawks have spotted a 14-0 deficit to the Wahconah Warriors. One touchdown pass and one touchdown run has been the difference, and two extra point kicks for Wahconah. And Frontier has yet to get on the board, although they've had some success moving the ball, but Wahconah has had the answers to shut them down. The shotgun again. This gun, it's a handoff inside. They do a good job spreading that defense, and they work the ball down to about the 41-yard line of Frontier. That is good for a first down. Ball spotted at the Frontier 41. Double wideouts on the far side. Jettaway in the gun. Spread formation. Once again, they go inside on the draw. And that is haste. That's noise that time with the carry. And he gets down to about the 36. That's good for about five. So 4 or 5 yards a clip on those runs, which have been the most successful and consistent offensive patterns for Wahconah tonight. Jenoway, he's going to pass. Fires it across the middle, tries to lead the receiver too far in front, incomplete. And that's going to bring up a third down and about five.
Third and five.
Third and five from the 36 of Frontier. Inside handoff again. That time he got hooked by one of the Frontier linemen. Did the ball carrier.
Washburn on the carry.
That was Washburn, and he is brought down after a gain of about one, maybe two. And that's going to bring up fourth and three.
And I'm going to
have a hard time believing they're not going to go for it here.
Fourth and four.
One back, this time under center. And the pitch goes to the back, and he's definitely got the first down and probably more as he is down to about the 25-yard line. Another 26 or 7. We'll see where they spot it. But they're in business again with a fresh set of downs. Kay Gwantra on the stop. Ball spotted at the 27. And once again, Jenoway goes back to the shotgun. Rolling out. Firing it downfield. Incomplete. Actually threw it behind the intended receiver. Couldn't turn around, and Burris couldn't quite control it, so it brings up second and 10. I'm amazed by the sheer numbers on this Wahconah team. They have tons of kids. Huge program. Shotgun formation again for Jenoway. And he's going to keep it, then hand it off the last second. And Frontier reads it well and swarms and holds the guy to about a gain of only maybe two. I'll bring up third and eight.
66, Luke Parsons.
.936 to go in the half. 14-0 Wahconah. And they are knocking on the door again. Jenoway out of the shotgun. Fires downfield. That pass is complete. That's going to be first down. Breaks the tackle, and he's going to go in. Did they get him before he got before he broke the plane? Yeah, it's the pass complete to Burris. That's going to bring up a First and goal for Wahconah. Burris did a great job breaking a couple of tackles there. And Wahconah can make it a 3-touchdown lead with one running play here. The pitch goes to the running back, and he is into the end zone for the touchdown. Hastings with the 1-yard touchdown run to make it 20-0. Extra point attempt upcoming for Patrick Butler. Candy is flying everywhere. Snap is down, the kick is up, and once again, Butler splits the uprights. And will come back up the field with the score. Wahconah 21, Frontier nothing. Redhawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Hildreth and Landry back deep again at the 5 for the Redhawks. Waiting the kick from Butler, who's routinely kicked the ball to the 5 or beyond every time he's had to in this game. That one's a little bit shorter. Rolls down to about the 7. Picked up by Landry. He's brought down at about the 15-yard line. We'll see where they spot it.
Brought down by Wyatt Fleischer. First and 10 Frontier from their own 22.
Ball is spotted just outside the 21 for the Redhawks, and Miles Freeman will go to work again, trying to get something going offensively. Out of the shotgun, Freeman's going to hand it off, and it looked like a broken play. You're going to get about a yard.
Yielders on the carry, brought down by number 77, Kyle Noy.
That's the senior. Alperin Yidlis.
1 yard pickup, second and 9.
He gets 1 second and 9 from the 22. Freeman, screen pass to Landry, complete. Landry gets chopped down at about the 28, so that was a nice little swing pass out of the backfield.
Brought down by Kyle Gazzillo.
It's going to bring up third and about 3. Ball spotted at the 33-yard line of Frontier. 7:47 to go. And this might be a 20-second timeout as Freeman confers with Frontier coach Don Gordon. And now the rest of the team is going to come over, so it's probably going to be a full timeout. Other action tonight in local high school football, tournament action, excuse me. In the Division 4 1A semifinal over at Bordeaux Field in Turner's Falls. The Turner's Falls Indians are hosting the Pioneer Panthers. Turner's Falls seeded number 1 in that division, and Pioneer seeded number 4. They got in with a win last week against Mohawk. And we saw that Turner's Falls team last week, and they are definitely the real deal. Would not surprise me at all to see them in a final in 4A, although they won't be going to Foxborough. 4A, for some reason, will not be playing at Foxborough. Only divisions 1 through 4 will play at Gillette Stadium. My guess is 4A will probably play at Westfield State. So third and about 4 upcoming. Ball spotted inside the 30. And Freeman takes the snap, runs left side. She hands it off and run left side, and let's see what they got. That was Landry again with a host of blockers, but he got ripped down and lost some yardage there. It'll be fourth and about eight. So Wahconah very much has Frontier scouted, and they know what Landry is going to do. And he had lots of company that time. So it's going to have to be a punting situation for the Redhawks. If there were any Wahconah scouts that saw that game last week with Turner's, they knew exactly what to do. Turner's just basically won that game up front. And that's been the case tonight. Miles back to kick it for the Hawks. Gets the snap, boots it away, end over end kick. Still a catch called for at about the 37 of Frontier. So Wahconah will have a short field to play with. We might have a flag on the play. Looks like a little conferring going on. Illegal procedure on Frontier. Are they going to make him kick it again, or are they just going to take it? Are they going to decline it? Makes sense, because that's pretty good field position. It's not going to get much better than that, I don't think.
Wahconah will take over first and 10 from the Frontier 47.
So Wahconah gets the ball again with a short field, as if they needed it with a 21-0 lead. And here comes Genoway. Under shotgun again. And he fires it to the right side, pass complete. And brought down.
Genoway's pass complete to Washburn.
And that was Washburn with the catch.
Number 30, Corbin Blight.
And that's going to bring up a second and about four.
Second and four.
That Connor Washburn is very quick. Senior, 5'10", 170, wide out. Also run over the backfield a couple of times tonight. Genoway hands it off to Hastings, and Hastings breaks the tackle, goes blasting up the middle, touchdown. Wow, that was quite a bit of running.
43-yard touchdown, Camper.
So that's Hastings' second touchdown of the game, 33 yards. And that makes it 27-0 with the extra point upcoming. How many times have we seen Landry or Worley do that this season? And Hastings gave them a taste of their own medicine on that one. That was just a nice, nicely run ball. Snap down, kick is up, and it is good. We'll come back up the field with 5:53 to go in the first half. And it is Wahconah. Blowing it open. 28. Frontier nothing. Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Chris Collins, Zach Pelt, Kevin Murphy back out here at Wahconah Regional School with the Warriors as advertised. Very strong. Up 28-0 on the Frontier Red Hawks as Butler to kick it away for the Warriors. And he kicks this one down to Landry at about the 6-yard line. He bobbles it, gets back the other way, slips and gets crunched and brought down inside the 10. Good pursuit by Wahconah.
Landry on the return.
That's gonna be first and 10 from about the 7-yard line, it looks like.
Brought down by number 53, Mike Fortin.
Ball is actually at the 17-yard line. Freeman takes the snap, gives the handoff inside. A couple of yards there for Morawski, maybe.
Morawski on the carry, brought down by Kyle Gazzillo.
Actually, looks like no gain on the play. Gonna bring up
no
second and 10.
No gain on the play, second and 10.
Pass over the middle, deflected, incomplete. As diving for it for Frontier was Ito McMillan. He couldn't quite hang on to it. It was deflected. That'll bring up third and 10 from the 17. Freeman, the throw. Fired over the middle, incomplete. Pass intended for Kiernan Freeman. And that's going to bring up a punting situation for Frontier.
Incomplete. We'll bring up a fourth and 10.
Miles back in his own end zone to boot it away. And it gets booted down and rolls to about the midfield mark. So decent punt for Frontier. And Wahconah will pick it up at their own 49 to start this next drive. They're up 28-0. 4:33 to go in the second quarter. We'll recap the scoring before the start of the second half.
First to Ken Wahconah from their own 48.
Genoway in the gun. One player in motion. And the handoff goes down the left sideline. This looks like it's Schlechter.
Washburn on the carry.
Sorry, that was Washburn, excuse me. Connor Washburn gets a first down on that run.
Down by Miles Freeman.
That's that counter run. Frontier runs that quite often with Landry, and that time Washburn got it down to inside Frontier territory to about the 35-yard line. First and 10, Wahconah. Genoway to roll out. Quick pass complete, wide open on the corner, cutting back across the middle and going into the end zone. There was nobody on him.
Genoway to Henderson for a touchdown.
And that one was well executed. Makes it 34-0. The extra point upcoming. And once again, Patrick Butler has kicked the extra point. Snap is down, kick is up, and good.
Butler's kick is good. 35-0.
So come back up the field with the score. Wahconah 35, Frontier nothing. This is Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. So a 35-yard touchdown pass from Will Genoway to Sam Henderson. Extra point kick by Butler. Makes it an even 35-zip with 3:48 to go in the second quarter. It has been all Wahconah so far. Once again, Hildreth and Aaron Landry back deep. And again, deep kick. This time it goes to Hildreth at the 5. Hildreth goes up left side again, gets a nice run down the left sideline. That's the second time Hildreth has gone long with that return. And he's brought down past midfield at about the 45 of Wahconah. So Matt Hildreth, one of the few bright spots for Frontier, has been a couple of long returns for him in this game. They're going to say he was out right at midfield. So it's going to be first and 10 at the 50 for the Redhawks. motion goes Landry. Gets the handoff. Coming around right side, and he is swarmed by a bunch of Wahconah tacklers. They've read that play pretty much every time they've run it, although Landry had success with that in the first quarter, but not since. That's going to be a loss of at least one. Yep, loss of one. Second and 11 from the 49 of Frontier. Clock in motion with less than 3 minutes to go in the half. Freeman on a shotgun. Rolling out left, being pursued. Fires the pass, incomplete. And Miles ends up on the ground as he was going to get sacked if he didn't get that ball away. Wasn't a bad pass, just couldn't quite hang on to it. That'll bring up third and 11. That was real good pursuit by Wahconah. That was the first time they've really penetrated that backfield and rushed Miles Freeman to throw the ball. Three receivers to the left. Morawski's in the left slot. And Freeman out of the shotgun. Quick pass over the middle, complete. And brought down at about the 41-yard line. And I believe that might be Kiernan that cut that one. Let's see who the number is. Yep, it was Kiernan Freeman. And that's going to be up fourth and short. Fourth and about a yard. So that was good for about 10. Just outside the 45-yard line. So the brothers Freeman hook up for a nice game.
We've got the fourth and one.
Fourth and one. Inside give, and they did not get the, I don't think they got it. That was good pursuit. And that's gonna be a turnover as Wahconah does a great job stacking the line. And that quick inside give did not make it. Now, ordinarily, that would have been a play that would be money in the bank for a Seth Gawanter or for even a Stephen Wordley, but that time they just got flat-out stuffed by the line of Wahconah, and they'll take over on downs. First and 10, Wahconah from their own 46. Less than 2 minutes to play in the second quarter. And once again, out of the gun. Quick pass over the middle, complete. As once again, tackle's broken and finally they bring him down at about the 45-yard line. And that's Tom Burris, the big wide receiver, number 23, first and 10 from the 45. And once again, the Warriors pass over the middle, complete. Incomplete, rather, goes through the hands of the defender. Washburn was the intended receiver, went through his hands, and that'll stop the clock with 1:22.
Brings up a second and 10.
To go in the half. Genoway under center, in the shotgun, rather. Quick screen pass, complete. And down the left sideline he goes. And is he going to go in? He's out of bounds at about, looks like, the 6-yard line. Again, great little screen pass. That was Noyes again. Ran it down. Refs are conferring. Block in the back, it looks like. Who are they going to get? This is on Frontier. Wahconah, was it Wahconah? Blocking the back on Wahconah, okay.
Blocking the back.
So they're gonna count the run, or the pass, and they're gonna knock him back 10. So that will set him up at about the 11-yard line, it looks like. Shotgun again, rolling right. So now he's going to keep it, he's going to get brought down at about the line of scrimmage. That time, There's no one to pass to.
The other way.
He got racked up pretty good by Andre Prishbuck, Chuck.
Timeout, Wahconah.
And Hildreth was in there as well. Wahconah will call time with 43.0 seconds left. And the second and 10 upcoming as Wahconah leads 35-0. This is Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Second and 10 upcoming as the Warriors want to punch one more in here before the half. They lead 35-0 as it is. Genoa under center. And he's going to pass to the left corner of the end zone. Incomplete. Good defensive play by Frontier. Again, that was Matty Hildreth who's having a great game. That'll stop the clock with 35.4 seconds. It'll bring up a third and 10.
Brings up a third and 10.
Ball's actually spotted outside the 20, about the 21-yard line. Genoa again. Once again goes to the corner of the end zone, and that time he finds the receiver. Beautiful pass. Touchdown.
Genoa to Washburn. Touchdown, Wahconah.
So that is a real backbreaker that makes the score 41-0 with 25 seconds left. Extra point upcoming. That is three touchdown passes in this half for Genoa. Snap is down, kick is up, and Butler hits the uprights again. And we come back up the field with the blowout on. The score. Oh, excuse me, that was actually no good. He actually missed one. So the kick fails, and we'll come back up with the score. Wahconah 41, Frontier nothing. This is Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Collins, Kevin Murphy, and Zach Pelk back out here at Wahconah Regional School. We knew this was going to be a tough one for the Frontier Redhawks. I don't think we expected it to be quite this tough. But Wahconah leads 41-0, 25 seconds left in the first half. Three touchdown runs, three touchdown passes, pretty much an awesome offensive performance by the Warriors of Wahconah, who are the real deal as the number one seed in Division IV. Pat Butler to boot it again. Again, down to Landry. It bounces. Landry's going to pick it up at about the 4. Runs it up left side and is brought down after about maybe a 6-yard return. We'll see where they spot it, and we'll start off.
Landry on the return.
Will likely be the final drive of this half by the Frontier Redhawks. Again, the Hawks have come out with a different set. They were used to running a full house power backfield, double wing. They've come out with a shotgun formation to spread things out a bit. And while it's done some, you know, had some success, not nearly enough to be competitive with a very good Wahconah defense. Freeman out of the gun again. And he gets the snap, rolls left. He's going to keep it, and he's going to get sacked. And that will bring to an end the first half of play, mercifully. The end of one half, and it is the Wahconah Warriors 41, the Frontier Redhawks nothing. Second half action upcoming. This is Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. One. Chris Collins, Kevin Murphy, and Zach Pelk back out here at Wahconah Regional School. Tough first half for the Frontier Redhawks. They trail 41-0. The third quarter action upcoming. Six scores in that first half, starting off with a Burris 13-yard touchdown pass. And the Patrick Butler kick made it 7-0. And then Noyes, the 2-yard touchdown run with a Butler kick to make it 14-0. Hastings, a 1-yard touchdown run. And a Butler kick made it 21-0. Hastings again, 33-yard run. And a Butler kick made it 28-0. And then Henderson caught a 35-yard touchdown pass from Well, Genoway and the Butler kick made it 35-0, and then Washburn with a 21-yard pass. And the kick was missed by Butler, who's actually human, to make it 41-0, which is where we stand. And Wahconah will get the ball to start this half as Frontier will kick it. Frontier received the ball to start the game. Obviously, things not going the way the Red Hawks would like at this point, but there are two halves in this game, and there's an opportunity to put some points on the board and make a showing of it, but they would have to really have a Herculean effort and a major breakdown by Wahconah for the Warriors not to win this game. Again, Frontier depleted. They're without Seth Gowanter and Stephen Wordley. But I got to wonder, even if they were in the lineup, whether things would be any different, because this is a very good Wahconah team. Hawks to kick it away. And this is Corbin Blight to boot it away for the Red Hawks. Short kick, and it's going to skip down to about the 19-yard line. And it's going to get wrapped back the other way. And big hit, and the Wahconah player is still on his feet. And he's finally stopped. But not brought down, but stopped at about the 23-yard line, which is where the Warriors will start off. And there's a flag down. We'll see what they get for a call here. There's an injured player down. It's a Frontier Redhawk. And there's a block in the back is going to be the call. And we'll see who's down. Looks like 73, which would be Cade Gowanter if it is him. Cade, of course, one of the defensive captains. Block in the back is going to be on Wahconah. Yeah, they'll knock it back. Ball will be spotted at the 9-yard line. We don't know. We're pretty sure it's Cade Gowanter who is down. He has helped back up. Or is that Matt Carlson? Can't tell from here. Whoever it is favoring their left leg. So it's not Matt, it's definitely Cade Gowanter, as Matt is on the field. So that's a tough loss. Another Gowanter goes down to injury. I don't know if he'll return or not, but his brother Seth is out there on the crutches. So first and 10 from the 9-yard line. For the Warriors. Handoff, and the Red Hawks bring the ball carrier down at about the noon. That was Nate Zink with the carrier, the ball rather. They bring him down at about the 10, so he gets about a yard. The quarterback rolling out right, that's Genoway. And brought down at about the 12 after a quick outlet pass. That brings up third and 5 from the 14 of Wahconah. 10:40 to go in the third quarter, 41-0, Wahconah with a big lead. Shotgun formation again. One back in motion. And the quarterback is going to keep it. There's brought down at about the line of scrimmage. Not a lot of room there. And he lost about a yard. That'll bring up fourth and about seven. So a three and out, a rare three and out for Wahconah. Back deep is Landry at about the Warrior 45. They didn't punt before. I don't know. Are they going to go for it here? It looks like they're going to go for it on fourth and six. They went for it before, and it paid off. Well, they do a quick kick instead. And it's taken at about the 46-yard line by Lander, and he is brought down at about the, looks like the
Landry on the return.
38 maybe? 38, 37-yard line, which is where the Red Hawks will start.
Acevedo on the tackle. First and 10 Frontier. From the Warrior, 37.
So short field here for Miles Freeman as the Red Hawks would like to get something going here, get some points on the board, erase that goose egg. Freeman in the shotgun, ball is loose, fumble, picked up, and they're going to bring it back all the way. And that was just a missed exchange. And it results in a touchdown for the Wahconah Warriors.
Mike Thornton with a fumble return for a touchdown.
So the defense gets one for the Wahconah Warriors. And that makes it 47-0. I'm going to say that's about a 60-yard fumble recovery. I would say it's about 60 yards. Going to go for a two-point conversion. They fired into the end zone. It's going to be incomplete.
Girardi's pass.
And that touchdown was Thornton. Who picked up the fumble, brought it back 60 yards. And the two-point conversion is no good. And we'll come back up the field with the score. Wahconah 47, Frontier nothing. This is Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Well, after scoring six offensive touchdowns in the first half, the Wahconah Warriors defense gets one with a 60-yard fumble recovery return by Thornton to make it 47-0. Back deep, Hildreth. And they cook this one short. And it's taken and not much of a return at all. And they'll bring it to about the 30-yard line, which is where Frontier will take over.
Brandon Plutwell on the return, brought down by number 70. 78, Rob Genoway on the tackle.
First and 10 from the 31 for Miles Freeman and the Red Hawks. Inside give. Goes up the middle. And that was Blight, I believe, that ran that one. Good for about 3 yards. That'll bring up third and 7. Well, second and 7, excuse me, from the 34. Freeman, another inside give, and cutting back across and hit immediately was Landry. He gets a couple of yards there. That'll bring up about a third and a long 3, around 4.
Brings up a third and 4.
Ball at the 36-yard line. Freeman. Inside give goes to Landry again. And he's got a first down up to about the 44-yard line. Make it the 43.
Brought down by number 4, Ethan Scott. First and 10, Frontier.
They're going to spot the ball at about the 44-yard line. First and 10 for the Red Hawks. Miles in the shotgun. And he's going to throw it. Pass complete over the middle. And the pass complete to one of his favorite targets. That's number 15, Cole Price. Catching his first ball of the game and good for a first down. And they're inside Wahconah territory to about the 43. Freeman again out of the gun. Rolling left side, gonna keep it. Cuts back across the middle and gets about a yard if he's lucky. Freeman, he may have lost a yard. We'll see where they spot it.
Brought down by number 53, Mike Fortin.
And that option really hasn't fooled Wahconah much tonight. They've been able to stay at home and sniff that out. There's no gain on the play. That'll bring up second and 10. Clock is in motion, 6:20 to go in the third quarter. Again, 47-0. Wahconah with the lead. Frontier with the ball. Miles to throw. Over the middle. Pass is incomplete. As intended receiver could not quite hang on to it. So he got wrapped up immediately. That'll bring up third and 10. That was actually Blight that was that ball was intended for. Gun again. And a handoff goes around the end. And not going much of anywhere there, as that was Yidlitz. Sorry, Ito McMillan, the freshman with the run. And that's going to bring up fourth and 9. That's a gain of about 1.
Brought down by Tanner Hill.
And we'll see if Frontier decides to go for here. It looks like they're probably going to. Not much to lose here. Motion goes McMillan again. Whistle, and I think we got an illegal formation or illegal procedure. It looks like someone might have jumped on the far side. Yep. False start on Frontier. They'll knock him back 5. That'll bring up 4th and 14. Looked like the far end left a little too early. Ball spotted outside the 45-yard line to about the 46. Hawks going to go for it. Once again, Ito goes in motion. And the ball goes to Landry on the fake, and he's not going to get much farther than the 45, and they will turn it over on downs and give the ball back to Wahconah.
Number 16, Dane Campbell.
First and 10 ball will be spotted actually at the 46, which is where Wahconah will take over. Just under 5 minutes to go in the third quarter. Wahconah with a 47-0 lead. We'll see if they call out the dogs here a little bit, as this one's pretty much academic. It's one of those situations where, you know, you don't want to humiliate anybody, but it's tough to tell these guys not to play football when they've worked all year for this game. Looks like a lot of new fresh jerseys in there. Inside give. It's going to be first down yardage and more, as they're going to bring him down at around the 41. Yeah, it looks like a lot of reserves are in there right now, which is, I think, the right move. Yeah, this is by far the toughest draw Frontier has had this season. This is a very good Wahconah team, and they're going to go far. Inside give again. He gets 4 or 5 yards, pushes ahead to about the 40. That's Nate Zink, the sophomore fullback, 5'5", 145.
Down by number 51, Pat McGranigan.
And he got a first down on that one, it looks like. Referee's now conferring. Personal foul on Frontier. And a personal foul on Wahconah, so they're going to offset and replay the down. Okay, so the play will count. It'll bring up second and looks like about 6 from the spot. Tim Lennon running in the play for the Wahconah Warriors. 2nd and 5 from the 47. That's not the 47, that's the 42. Now the lefty fires it downfield. Pass is incomplete.
Pass is incomplete.
As
intended for number 5, Tim Clayton.
That'll bring up 3rd down and about 6. Same formation, shotgun. This time the quarterback's going to keep it. Go off left tackle, breaks a tackle. He's near front. Near first down yardage, but I don't know if he got it.
Down by number 10, Miles Freeman.
That was Nealand. And that's going to bring up 4th and about 1. 3 minutes to go in the third quarter. Gerard, it looks like, is running the offense for Wahconah. And he's going to fire it over the middle, complete. And that's good for first down yardage, as they went for it on 4th and 1, and they completed the pass. So
pass complete to Tanner Hill.
We'll bring it farther down into Frontier territory. Gerard to Hill. And that's going to bring up a first down, and we'll see where they spotted it. At the 14. Gerard hands it off up the middle. He bounces off the tackler and runs it into the end zone for the touchdown.
B.J. Farmer in for the touchdown. 22 yards touchdown scamper.
That'll make it 53-0. Yard run for Farmer, and that makes it 53-0 with the extra point. Kick is good, and we'll come back up the field with the score. The Wahconah Warriors 54 and the Frontier Redhawks nothing. This is Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. Chris Collins, Zach Pelk, and Kevin Murphy back out here at Wahconah Regional. The Warriors' second team has scored now. Their defense has scored in this half, and the reserves have scored to make it 54-0. Kick goes out of bounds, which means they'll have the chance to either knock him back 5 yards to re-kick or take the ball where it is. I'm guessing they'll probably re-kick it, but... So Frontier will take the ball at the 30-yard line. .145 to go in the third quarter. Frontier now with the ball at their own 30. As they trail by a lot. Fumble snap, but they're able to hang on to it. And running up the right side, good job by Miles Freeman to turn nothing into something as he took the fumble snap, ran it all the way down to the Wahconah 40 for a Red Hawk first down. One thing's for sure, number 10 has not stopped playing this game, no matter how far down they are. Miles, of course, a senior, one of the leaders of this team. And he will get a first and 10, and he'll take a break as the Redhawks have the ball at the 30 of Wahconah. Hildreth now under center. Hildreth scrambles and does not quite make it back to the line of scrimmage. He got whacked pretty good. Loss of one. Matt Hildreth, of course, is the backup quarterback on this team, and he'll be the quarterback of the future, I believe, next year. For the Hawks. He's only a sophomore. Second and 11 from the 41 of Wahconah as the final 30 seconds tick down in quarter number 3. This one was academic a while ago. Quick screen pass complete to Ito. And Ito gets a couple of yards. Ito McMillan up to about the 36, make it the 37 of Wahconah. Ito McMillan is just a freshman. You'll see him again for a number of years. A lot of speed there. And that'll bring to an end the third quarter. We played three quarters here from Wahconah Regional. At the end of three, it's Wahconah 54, Frontier nothing. This is Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television.
At the end of the third quarter.
Chris Collins, Zach Pelk, Kevin Murphy here at Wahconah Regional, final quarter of this one. The Redhawks have the ball, 3rd and 7 on the 37 of Wahconah. Trying to get something moving. Inside give goes to Landry. He gets wrapped up and brought down. Not a whole lot of room there. They knock him back a couple of yards. It'll be 4th and about 8. Just outside the 38-yard line. Frontier will go for it here. There's nothing to lose. Hildreth is the wide out on the right side. White in the backfield. Freeman now. Running right side. Freeman's going to keep it. Fakes the pass. Cuts across. First down yards or more. Miles Freeman down the right sideline and brought down. What a play by Miles Freeman. First down yardage on fourth and eight. And he's inside deep in the red zone on Wahconah for the first time in this game. That's a first and 10. Looks like it's just about outside the 10-yard line. Actually, the 14, excuse me. Now, again, handoff goes inside.
Fumble on the play.
Fumble.
Covered by Landry.
And Aaron Landry is able to recover the fumble. Hawks lose a yard on that one. Ball spotted at the 15. Second and 11 from the 15-yard line. Freeman again. Fires it down the sideline. Complete! Is he in? Touchdown!
Freeman's pass is complete to number 7, Matt Hildreth.
So the Frontier Redhawks get on the board. Hildreth with a 15-yard touchdown pass for the 6 points. So it's 54-6. The conversion attempt upcoming. So Matt Hildreth from Miles Freeman breaks the shutout. And they're going to go for two. Freeman runs it right side, tucks it, keeps it. Did he get in? Touchdown. That's 2-point conversion. So Freeman's run makes it 54-8. And we'll come back up the field with the score. Wahconah Field 54, Frontier 8. Red Hawk football on Frontier Community Access Television. So Matt Hildreth, a 15-yard touchdown pass for Miles Freeman. And a point after run by Freeman makes the score 54-8. With 10 minutes left to go in the contest. Corbin Blight to kick it for the Red Hawks. Blight kicks a bit of a worm burner. That's picked up by the Wahconah deep man. Cuts back across. Still on his feet. Down the right sideline. What some speed. And Blight brings him down. And that was Nate Zink, the sophomore speedster. Who brings it all the way up to midfield, which is where Wahconah will take over. First and 10 from the 49-yard line of the Warriors. Make it to 48. So Matt Hildreth had quite a game. A couple of good kickoff returns and a touchdown, the only touchdown of the game. Caught from Miles Freeman. Gerard under center. Inside give. And brought down at about the 49 of Frontier. That'll bring up third and about 7 from the 48. Shotgun formation again. Inside give again. Up past the 45. Ball may have scored it loose at the end there. Going to call it down at the 45. It was Farmer with the run. It's going to bring up 3rd and 3 from the 45.
Brought down by number 63, Joe Hildreth.
8:34 to go in the game.
Third and three.
Shotgun formation. Once again, inside give. That time he goes nowhere. Swarmed by the Red Hawk defense. That'll knock him back a couple more yards. It'll bring up fourth and long. Ball spotted at the 46. That's going to bring up fourth and four. Just under 8 minutes to go in the game. Hawks have fared better against this second unit of Wahconah. That first unit is plenty deadly, and they're going to be tough to contain in the final. Quick shotgun snap, quarterback keeper, but he's going to get roughed up and knocked down way back. And that's going to be a turnover on downs and a little bit of a victory there for the Frontier defense.
Frontier will take over on downs.
And Frontier will take it over at the 49 of Wahconah. So the Red Hawks have a chance to punch a little one more in here and get a little closer. First and 10 at the 49 of the Warriors. Inside give, nothing doing as the Warriors swarm. Gang tackle. That was Blight, I believe, that carried that one. Actually, excuse me, it wasn't. It was Herbert, Sam Herbert on the carry. Ball at around midfield. Second and 11. Inside give again goes to Herbert. And Herbert gets up across midfield to about the 47, 48. It's a gain of three, it looks like. Third and nine. Inside give. Counter run down to close to the 40-yard line. That was Edo McMillan with the run.
Brought down by number 57, Jake Scalise.
And you got a lot of Frontier subs in there now. As this is a battle of the second string of both of these clubs. A look at the future, perhaps. Inside give. Up the right side to Herbert. And he's got a first down, looks like, and more. They'll move the chains. 5.5 to go in the game. Clock is in motion.
Brought down by number 40, Jake Guy.
Motion goes Herbert again. Inside give. And once again, first down yardage. Is that Ito again? Ito McMillan with the run. First down again, they'll move the chain. So this is a unit's running the ball very, very well. And again, an inside give. And Ito got stood up, it looked like, that time.
McMillan on the carry again, no gain. Brought down by a host of Warriors.
That'll bring up second and 10 from the 15. This has been a fun Frontier team to watch this season. regardless of what's happened in the last couple of games. They have had quite a year. Nothing to be ashamed of. And to get here was an accomplishment. Rolling out right, and the quarterback is going to be sacked. That was Garrett DeForest, the freshman, in the pocket. And that's a loss of about five. That'll bring up third and 15. Garrett DeForest, a freshman, rolling out. Fires it downfield. This is going to be knocked down. Was it intercepted? Nope, incomplete. That'll bring up fourth down. Let Corbin Blake kick a field goal here. Wouldn't that be fun? Fourth down. Don't know if that's going to happen, but could always try it. As I mentioned, Patrick Butler for Wahconah was making 45-yard field goals in practice. They're going to go for it, though, on fourth and 15. DeForest is going to fire it downfield again. Incomplete. Nice attempt, and that'll turn it over on downs as he got smacked at the end of that play. So Wahconah will take it over, first and 10, going the other way. That was a nice little exchange, though, by that young unit. They get some players out there, some good look at the good looking future for the Frontier Redhawks. As those guys have played together for a while, you can just tell they know, and they're very, very quick off the ball, too. Not that the current offense isn't quick off the ball, but these guys, they'll be inheriting this offense next year. 3:19 to go in the game, and Wahconah with the ball now. It's Gerard now under center. Takes the snap. Inside give. They run it left side, and they cut back the other way. And finally, ripped down to the ground by Hildreth. Flag behind the play. I don't know if they're going to get Maddie for unnecessary roughness. I'm not sure what the call is going to be, but definitely a flag down. That was a relatively brisk tackle he made. I didn't necessarily think it was a penalty, but let's see what the call is. Call is going to be face mask. Face mask is declined. So I'm going to say that Matt, he got the face mask when he brought the kid down. Matt, I think, probably has a different view of it. But it's going to be a face mask, and they're going to push it. I thought it was declined, but maybe there was a second penalty that was declined. But it's a 15-yard penalty against the Redhawks. Automatic first down for Wahconah. Clock is in motion again. Ball is spotted at the 49 of Wahconah, and they have it first and 10. And the gun again is Gerard. Snap goes through his legs, he'll have to eat it. And he'll fall down at about the 40-yard line. Clock is still in motion, so that's a loss of about nine on that one. That'll bring up second and 19. So Wahconah will move on to the finals next week, and the Frontier Redhawks will await an opponent that they will be told about. And of course, they still have Thanksgiving Eve at Mohawk, which is a traditional rivalry game. That's always an interesting matchup. I think Frontier will be a heavy favorite in that game, despite the injuries to Worthley and Gowanter. Anything can happen, though, in a rivalry game. Quick inside handoff. They get back two of the yards they lost. And the clock will remain in motion. That'll bring up third down and about 17.
Brought down by number 51, Pat McGranahan.
As the clock continues to tick down, final seconds in this one. This one was academic long ago. I keep saying that, but not much other way to describe it. It's been one of those nights, and Wahconah has been the better team. Frontier has hung in there, though, and has not given up, which I give them credit for. Other teams might have just packed it in a long time ago. Inside give as they push the pile up to about midfield. And we're down to about a minute left, and they might get one more playoff. It'll be fourth down and about nine. As the tomahawk chop, which you can't do in some places, they apparently have no problem with that concept here in Dalton. Well, the Wahconah Warriors are halfway to a Super Bowl appearance. Well, they will be in 20 seconds anyway. High snap goes over the quarterback's head. He's going to have to eat it. Ball is still knocked loose and it's still squirting around. It's not going to matter because Frontier will get the ball back, but they're going to have no time to do anything. Ball, clock is stopped with 7 seconds left. They might get a playoff, try to score, but I don't know that they'll get time to do it. Good news is the Redhawks did break the shutout with the Maddie Hildreth touchdown pass of 15 yards from Miles Freeman. And they might be able to punch one more in here. And of course, the Freeman run made the score 54-8. They'll get one more crack at the end zone if they so choose to take it. DeForest under center, and he'll take a knee. So they're not even going to try for the end zone. And that's a good way to end it. So the final score from Wahconah Regional, the number one seed Wahconah Warriors defeat the Frontier Redhawks by a count of 54-8. The only Frontier score again came when Manny Hildreth caught the 15-yard touchdown pass from Miles Freeman. Freeman with a two-point conversion run. And that creates your final. Frontier now goes on to play an as-yet-to-be-determined opponent in the final week of the extended season. And then, of course, they have the Thanksgiving Eve traditional rivalry game against the Mohawk Warriors. That game will be played in Buckland. We will be able to see that game on tape delay on Frontier Community Access Television. That'll do it for our coverage from this Division IV semifinal game. For Zach Pelk, our camera people, Kevin Murphy, the executive producer, I'm Chris Collins. The final score for the final time, Wahconah 54, the Frontier Redhawks 8. So long from Dalton. This is Redhawk Football on Frontier Community Access Television.